Okay, children, in last video we have done topic highlighting text. Okay, yellow color you are seeing, no? It is highlighted. India is famous for its beautiful monuments. Okay, in yellow color we have highlighted this text. Okay, so highlight button, font style, font size, font color, bold, italic and underline, all these are part of font group. Okay, now our next topic is applying text effect. Children, I don't have Microsoft Word 2010. I have version 2007. Okay, so in 2007, no text effect button I don't have in home tab. Okay, so but in your book it is given. Okay, so from book you can understand it. First of all, to apply text effect, no, you have to select text. Then you have to go to home tab. Here it is written clearly. Select text to apply text effect. Then on the home tab, click on drop down arrow of the text effect button. Okay. So text effect command. This is button of text effect. Here you have to click. Okay. When you click on this button, no, it shows you different options. Here you can see. Outline, shadow, reflection and glow. This pop-up menu appears. Okay, it shows you different options of text effect. Clear? Four options are there. So first of all, select text, then click on text effect button. This menu appears. Okay, and now if you want to change outline, shadow, reflection, or you want to give glow effect, so whichever you want can be applied from here. So now turn page. Here you see, these are effects shown. Indian landmarks. Okay, here this is outline text effect, means outline of the text. Okay, border we generally draw around the text, hai na? So this is landmarks, Indian landmarks text it is, and its borders means outline are drawn. Then next is shadow effect, shadow text effect. So shadow you can see under the text. Okay, so there are different styles of shadow. Okay, so that can be whichever you like, you can apply it. Okay, then next is reflection, reflection text effect. This is reflection. Okay, so this also can be applied, and different styles are there of reflection, colors are also there, you can apply. Then this is glow, this is called glow effect. Okay, glow text effect. So these are four options which can be applied through the text effect button. Okay, so you all can try this in your MS Word 2010 version. Okay, I hope you understood. You have to select text first, then go to the text effect button, then menu appears with different styles of text effect, outline, shadow, reflection and glow, and apply those and see the result. Okay, different changes will be appearing on the text. Okay, so you can see those effects. Okay, now our next topic is changing case. Changing case, change case means here we can change the case of selected text. Lower case, generally we write in lower case letter, first sentence first letter capital, and till the full stop we write in small letters. Okay, so in MS Word, no, so change case option gives you five options. Sentence case, here you see this is change case button. Okay, and फर्स्ट वन सेंटेंस केस, सेकेंड इज लोअर केस, देन अपर केस, कैपिटलाइज ईच वर्ड एंड लास्ट वन इज टॉगल केस. ओके, सो वन बाय वन वी विल सी ऑल दिस चेंज केस ऑप्शंस. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हियर सिलेक्ट टेक्स्ट. फर्स्ट स्टेप सिलेक्ट टेक्स्ट. हियर इन दिस हेडिंग नो ऑल लेटर्स आर इन कैपिटल. All letters are in capital. Now, if I select sentence case, okay, sentence case. Okay, children. So we are going to change case. Okay, here you see. There are many famous landmarks, full stop, then some of them are. So, here, this is already in sentence case. Sentence case means first letter capital and till full stop, letters will be in small letters. So, this is sentence case. Okay. Now, we will change it in lower case. When you click lower case, you can see capital T change into small t. Capital S here, that is also turned into small letter. Okay, here you see. All letters have become in small. Now, if I click on uppercase, so all letters have now been uppercase. Capitalize each word means every word's first letter will be capital. Here you see. T, here A, here M, means first letter of the word is in capital and rest are in small. This is capitalize each word. Each word of the selected text, first letter capital, rest are in small. Okay. Understood? And next is toggle case. Toggle case. When you choose toggle case, so toggle case means here, letter which were in capital, now you can see, turn into small and small turn into capital. Okay, this is called toggle case. Okay, some S, here you see, S became small and OME became capital. Okay, R, here A small and RE became capital. So this is called toggle case. Understood? So this is change case option. Through this we can change the case. Okay. Five options are there: sentence case, lower case, upper case, capitalize each word, and toggle case. Okay. This is very simple. All of you can apply it easily. Now, next topic, aligning text, page number 50. Okay. So, alignment, it is the way in which text is placed on a page is called alignment. Okay, it's called alignment. How are we presenting text in page, that is called alignment. Means, suppose here you say, select text. Okay. So, all these texts we have presented on the left side. Now, there are four alignment buttons which can change the placement of text. Here you see, left alignment, this is center alignment, this is right alignment, and this is called justify alignment. Okay, so one by one we will see all these options. Clear? First of all, select text. So, text I have already selected. Now, by default, MS Word use left alignment. Okay, left alignment means text, it starts keeping from the left side. Then, if we click on right alignment, so you can see this change. Text has come over the right side. Now, if we choose center alignment, so you can see all text has come into center and each next line is at the center of its previous line. You can see each line, next line is at the center of its previous line, center. This is called center alignment. Okay, and now if we select whole text, okay, whole text, okay, so left alignment, this is center alignment, okay, right alignment, and this is justify. Okay, so this is four alignments. Justify alignment distributes text evenly between left and right margin, evenly. Okay, these are four alignments. Now we are going to create list, page number 51. Okay, for each type of command, no, there are keyboard shortcuts given in your book. Here you see page number 51, keyboard shortcuts are given. Okay, keyboard shortcut control plus L to left align, control plus R to right align, control plus E to center, and control J to justify. Okay, you have to remember these keyboard shortcuts. Okay, keyboard shortcuts you have to remember. Now this is done. List, so list can be prepared. Okay, so bulleted list and numbered list, there are two types of list, bulleted list and number list. List can be marked with dots. Okay, if we don't have to arrange list in any order, okay, means order is not required. Okay, so in that case we use bulleted list. Okay, bulleted list, and where we have to arrange list in some order, ascending order or in descending order, so in that case we use numbered list. Okay, yes. Now we are going to prepare list. So we have monuments list here, Red Fort, Taj Mahal, India Gate. Okay, so first of all I'm going to change size and bold. Okay, now bulleted list, here is the bulleted list option, this one. Okay, bullets, so click on this, it shows you what you want to apply, dark dot, hollow dot, then square. So these are bullets, whichever you want to apply, click on that. Okay, I have chosen this. So you can see list appear with this bullets. Understood? Okay. Now if you want to make list, want to arrange list with numbers, okay, so these are styles of numbering, 1, 2, 3 with parenthesis, capital ABC, small ABC, or if you want Roman numbers. So list can be prepared with this. Okay, so I am going to choose this 1, 2, 3, you can see. Okay, it's very simple, all of you can do this. First of all select list. Okay, select list, then go to the paragraph group, bullet button if you want to insert bullets, or number list, number button to make list numbered. Okay, clear? It's very simple, all of you can apply this. Now next is line spacing. Line spacing means space between lines. Vertical space between line is called line spacing. Okay. So this space between lines, it can be increased and can be decreased. Okay. You can see there is a space. Here you see. After the heading there is a space, and between these two lines space. Okay. So space can be changed, line space. Okay. So what you have to do, where you want to change the line spacing, first of all select that paragraph. I am choosing this one. Okay, paragraph chosen. Now go to the home tab, and here it is line spacing button. This is line spacing button. Click over it. So whichever space you want to give between lines, okay, if you choose 2.5, you can see space has been increased. Okay. This is space of 2.5. Okay. Now go again. Line spacing button. Click here and choose 1.0. Okay. So you can see the change. Okay. It's very simple. Click on line spacing button, whichever space you want to give. Okay, this is 3.0 and this is 1.0. Okay, this is called line spacing. Now so if you want to change space after and before the paragraph, after and before the paragraph, okay, so that is called paragraph spacing. Understood? Here you see. Suppose this paragraph chosen. Now to change paragraph spacing, we have to go to page layout tab. Which tab? Page layout tab. Here. Okay. Now there is paragraph indents. Okay, if you can see this, then spacing. Okay, before and after. So before, if you want to increase space, so upper arrow increases and lower arrow decreases. Understood, no? So I'm going to increase it. And after paragraph also, if you want to increase the space, okay, so this is done. Now you can see the changes. So much space has come. Okay, after, this is before paragraph and this is spaces after paragraph. Okay, I hope you understood this one. Okay, now again go to spacing and now decrease. Understood. So it has come obsolete. It is previous system, isn't it? So space before paragraph and space after paragraph can be increased or can be decreased. Understood? No? Very simple. Huh? All of you can do this. You can apply all these options. Okay. Now next topic is previewing. Printing a document. Okay, so for this we have to go to file button. I have office button, so I am going to click here. Okay, now go to the print option. Print option, and here is print preview. Okay, so this is print preview. Okay, this is the page we have typed. Okay, and it's showing for printing. Okay, this is print preview. Before printing, you can see what type of hard copy you are going to get from printer. Understood, no? Hard copy means print. Okay, printed document. Printed document. Printed document which we get through printer. That is called hard copy. Okay, so what sort of hard copy are we going to get? So through this print preview, we can get it. Okay, so it's very simple. Close. This is a normal screen. Okay, so print preview can be checked. Okay, and print, all of you know how to take print. Go to the file tab, print option. Okay, this is print dialog box. To take print out, no? Here, which pages? First of all, you have to select your printer, which printer you have. Then go to pages. If you want all pages print out, click on. If you want current pages print out, click on current page. Okay. Ranges can be specified. 1 to 15 page or 2 to 30 page, whichever you want. Then number of copies, how many copies you want, okay, of each page, 1, 2, 3, okay, how many, okay, so you can set from here. Okay, then finally you have to click on okay. You have to click on okay. So this way we can take print out. I hope you understood this chapter. Okay. Today we have done our fourth chapter, formatting in Word. Formatting in Word. So you have learned about how to make the text beautiful. Okay. By changing color, by changing size, by highlighting text. Okay, several options you have seen, how to change the line space, how to change paragraph space before and after paragraph. Okay, making text bold, italic and underline. I hope you understood these all these things. Then we have seen about it, creating list, bulleted list or numbered list. Okay, alignment we have seen. So children, this is our fourth chapter. In next video we will start our fifth chapter, more about internet. Okay, so children, do study at home, don't waste your time. Exams are very close now. Objective questions will be asked to you. Prepare your questions, prepare your chapter for exam. Okay, don't waste time. Bye.